Any name given to a person, place or thing is a noun. And there are five types of nouns. And they are, the first one is proper noun. Common noun. Collective noun. Abstract noun. And material noun. Okay, so noun means the name given to a person, place or thing is called a noun. So generally nouns are of five types. They are proper noun, common noun, collective noun, abstract noun and material noun. Okay, and in them, so we divide the nouns into one more type also. That is the countable or uncountable nouns. Okay, there is one more type, that is countable or uncountable nouns. Okay, so what is a proper noun? What is a proper noun? So if there is any particular name given to a person, place or thing, that is called proper noun. For example, take the names of the human. Okay, take the names of the human. So each and every person will be having a particular name. Like my name is Buelah. So the other ones, some Ajay, Raju, like that. Okay, so those names are called proper nouns. And when you take any historical monuments or any names of the rivers, lakes, seas, okay, the oceans, continents, etc. Each one has a particular name of its own. And that name is called a proper noun. Is that clear? Okay. So the examples for proper noun are okay, the examples for proper noun are those. So in human, we call them with some names, which is a particular name. And for fruit or vegetables or anything, they will have a particular name. And those particular names are called proper nouns. And next one is common noun. So what is a common noun? Common noun means the name given to any person, place or thing that is, which is in common. Like see, if we see a set of boys, if we don't know their name, we generally call them with the name boy, isn't it? Okay, so the words like boy, girl, then woman, man, these all are called common nouns. Similarly, when we take an institute, okay, just take it like an institute. So what institute is? Is it a proper noun or a common noun? Yes, it is a common noun because there can be any number of institutes. But for example, if it is an Indian Civils Institute, so what is it? Is it a common noun or a proper noun? Yes, it is a proper noun. Why? Because only some institutes will have that name. Okay. So in this way, proper noun means there should be a particular name. Common noun means anything can be called a common noun. Like, so if we take any example like temple. Temple, what temple is? Is it a common noun or a proper noun? Yes, it is a common noun. But if you say the Venkateshwara temple, what does that become? Yes, it becomes a proper noun. Okay, similarly, book is a common noun, some English book, it's a proper noun. So in that way, if there is any particular name, we call it as a proper noun. If there is no particularity, then it is called as a common noun. Just take the example animal. What is animal? Yes, it's a common noun. Okay, if I say zebra, zebra, what does that become? It becomes a proper noun. Okay, and next one is collective nouns. The main important one in this nouns is the collective noun. Okay, so what a collective noun is? The name given to a group. Okay, it can be a group of things, a group of people, or it can be a group of animals or anything like that. Okay, those names are called collective nouns. Okay, they are called collective nouns. So we shall see some list of collective nouns so that you can easily understand about it. Okay, okay, so just see, okay, yes, so instead of group you have to give the name. Okay, we shall see the names for all these ones. So group of animals, when we see a group of animals we call them as herd. Okay, herd. So what is the name for group of animals? It is herd. And next one, group of people. So when group of people comes, we use them with different words, like we can call them as assembly. We can also call them as a crowd. We can call them as group. And we can also call them as multitudes. Multitudes. Okay? So these are the names that we generally say for group of people. Okay? If group of people are found, we call them as a group. That's a common one. We generally say it. Okay? We also call them as a crowd. Okay? And similarly, the other ones are assembly and multitude. We can also say them as a multitude. Okay, clear? And next one is group of players. What are group of players called? They are called a team. Team. Then what are group of sailors called? They are called crew. C-R-E-W, crew. And next, group of ship. It's called fleet. Fleet. Okay? Group of ship. The place where ships are placed, that's called as harbor. Okay? Harbor is different from fleet. Next, group of sheep. They are also called herd. At the same time, they can also be called as cattle. Okay? Cattle. And next, group of grapes. So, any fruit which is in more in number, we call them as bunch. Bunch. Okay, so we can say bunch of grapes. Then anything which are more in number, they are called bunch. And next one, bunch of bananas. Okay, why? Because see, bananas are also interlinked. So we call them as bunch of bananas. We can call them as bunch of grapes. Okay, and next one. So if it is a group of flowers, we call them as bouquet. Bouquet. Okay, and if it is a set of soldiers, we call them as army. Yes. If they are set of singers, what are they called? If they are set of singers, what are they called? Choir. Choir. Okay, and if they are set of musicians, then it is called an orchestra. Why? Because in an orchestra, we see number of people who play a cajon, who play a drums, like that. Okay, so set of musicians, it is called orchestra. And also we can say band. We can also call them as troop. And for the set of soldiers also, we can use this term as troop. Okay, they are orchestra, band, and troop. Then what about okay, and next one is set of so set of soldiers is called army or troop, set of musicians is orchestra, band, or troop, and then it is the set of angry people, set of angry men. What are they called? Can anyone say? A group of angry men, what are they called? A group of angry men. Can anyone answer? Okay, they are called mob. Mob. And if it is a group of birds, then what are they called? If it is a group of birds, what are they called? That is called flight or flock. And remember, for sheep also we use the term flock. Okay, for sheep also we can use the term flock. So group of birds, they are called flight when they are flying in the air. When they are on the ground, they are called flock. Okay, and also like, see, we will be seeing number of birds, different birds will be there. So if the birds that are present are all of one type, like all parrots are present, only 10 parrots are present. Okay, so that 10 parrots are called flock. They are called flock. If there are different birds present, like birds, like pigeons, sparrows, parrots, okay, peacocks, then they are called flight. Did you understand the difference between flight and flock? Did you understand or not? Anyone who are watching online? Okay. Okay, so these are all the collective nouns. So what are collective nouns? The name given to a group is called collective noun. Then what about fish? What about fish? If a group of fish are present, what do we call them? What do we call them? If a group of fish are present, what do we call them? Yes, we call them as school. School. What? No, they are called bouquet. Group of fish, they are called school. Next, if it is a group of records, it is called pile of records. We call them as pile of records. Yes, it is choir, choir, choir. Okay. And then group of files, it is called a record. Set of pages, it is called a file. And then so set of grains, then it is called heap. You can take like rice also will be present in group only. Okay, so for rice, if it is poured like that, like a pile, then it is called heap. Okay, so for grains, rice, wheat, etc., flour also, we use the word heap. And for all these ones, we use these words. That is, group of records means it is called pile. Group of files, it is called record. And if it is a set of pages, it is called file. Clear about collective noun? So collective nouns means the words that are used to indicate a group, that is called collective noun. Okay, and next one is material noun. Okay, next one is material noun. The names given to the things which can be seen and touched, and also are materials. Okay, for example, the material nouns are like plastic. What plastic? It's a material noun because it can be seen and touched, and at the same time it's a material. Okay, so the name given to materials are called material nouns. In that, plastic, zinc, sulfate, gold, silver, clay, these all will become the material nouns. And by the way, what is the group of students called? What is the group of students called? Group of students. Can anyone say? Okay, the group of students is called class. Okay, group of students called class. And next, also the group of judges. So the group of judges regarding an issue, what are they called? They are called jury. Jury. Okay, they are called jury. And also group of they are called clergy. Okay, that doesn't indicate members, means that doesn't indicate that they are the normal church members. Okay, they are the members having particular who are appointed particularly for some particular purpose. Okay, if that group of pastors and the ones who are appointed to take care of the church, they are called clergy. At the same time, the one who is appointed to take care of the temple and along with the priest, they are also called clergy. Is that clear? Okay, then material nouns are the nouns that are used to represent a material, and the examples for those are gold, silver, aluminium, zinc, any other one like cotton. We can also take cotton. Okay, jute, even the sugarcane pulp, that's also a material. Okay, yes. Okay, dress is a completed one, so that's why we are taking cotton. Out of which is that made? That will be called a material noun. Clear? And the last one is abstract noun. Okay, and the next one is abstract noun. So what is an abstract noun? The names given to the feelings which cannot be seen or touched. Okay, the names given to the feelings of a person, they are called abstract nouns, because when we see the feelings, can we see them? When we think of the feelings, can we see them? No, we can't see. At the same time, can we touch them? No, we can't touch. Okay, so such type of nouns are called abstract nouns. There is only one difference between the material noun and the abstract noun. So material noun means it can be touched and seen, whereas the abstract noun cannot be touched or seen. Okay, only this makes the difference between the abstract noun and the material noun. Okay, so these are the five types of nouns. Is it clear? Okay, so in English we'll be having five types of nouns. One is proper, second one is material, third one is collective, and common and abstract. Okay, these are the five types of nouns. So the main important one in learning these nouns is you have to know how to write a plural form for these nouns. Okay, so there are some conditions on which we write a plural form for each word. Okay, so if you learn those forms, then you can easily do the correction of errors part. And you already know that the correction of errors part is one of the topics in your exam. Okay, so in the correction of errors part, this will be useful. At the same time, while writing the fill in the blanks, and also while doing the closed test, and also while changing one form of parts of speech into a noun form. Okay, for all these things, we should know how to write a plural form for a noun. And I already told you there is one more type of noun. What is that? It's a countable or uncountable noun. So what is a countable noun and what is an uncountable noun? Okay, the nouns that can be counted in number, they are called countable nouns. And the nouns which cannot be counted in number, they are called uncountable nouns. Okay, the nouns which can be counted in number. For example, if I ask you a question like how many students are present in the class, or how many students are listening to the class, you will just count them and say, okay, there are 10 or 20, like that. Okay, so it's a countable noun. So again, if I ask you a question like, how much work did you do today? The question is, how much work did you do today? So what will be your answer for that? How much work did you do today? Can you say it in numbers? Like I did one work, I did two works, I did three works. Can you say like that? No, we can't say. So there are some words which cannot be given, which cannot be said in numbers. Okay? And those words are called uncountable nouns. Uncountable nouns. So is that clear? Yes. So I'm going to give you some words. Just try to identify what type of noun is that. Okay, I'll give you some words. Just try to identify what type of nouns they are. So what are these nouns? Just try to identify which is among the types of nouns, which are the types of nouns. Okay? Tell me the answers. So tell me, what are the types of nouns in each one? What is Rama? What type of noun is that? It's a proper noun. Why? Because only few people will be having this name. Okay? Only a few people will be having that name. So it's a proper noun. And the next one? Yes, the next one is also a proper noun because it is also a name of a place. And next, what is boys? Yes, it's a common noun. Okay, similarly, books, common noun. Next, rivers. It is also a common noun. Next, army. What is army? Yes, it is a collective noun. Okay, because it is a group of soldiers, so it is collective noun. What about class? Yes, it's a collective noun. Then what about bacteria? What type of noun is that? Okay, it's also a collective noun. Why? Because bacteria won't be present in one single strand, so we can call it as a collective noun. Okay, and next one, material noun. Next one, material. Next one, abstract. 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 Then, what about the others? Protection. What is it? What type of noun is protection? First of all, tell me whether protection is a noun or not. Is protection a noun? Is it a noun? Yes, it's definitely a noun. Okay. Protect is a verb form. When we put T-I-O-N to that, it becomes a noun form. So protection is a noun and it is an abstract noun. It's an abstract noun. The excellence is also an abstract noun. Okay. Then strength. What is strength? What is strength? Can you see strength or can you touch it? No, we can't do that. So it is also an abstract noun. Next, wisdom. Yes, it is also an abstract noun. And voice. What is voice? Voice. What type of noun is that? Can anyone say? I'm only getting the numbers here. He visited to 552, visited to 95 3030 4055. So among them, can you say what voice is, what type of noun is that? Okay, so voice is a common noun. Yes, voice is a common noun. Why? Because it is commonly present to everyone. Okay, so that's why voice is a common noun. So now I hope you all are very clear about what nouns are. Okay, so nouns can be two types, countable and uncountable. If it is a countable noun, for countable nouns only we will be having a plural form. Okay, if it is not a countable noun, we can't write a plural form for that. For example, take the example of furniture. Furniture. So what type of noun is that? And also tell me whether it's a singular or a plural noun. Furniture. What type of noun is that? Okay, so furniture. Yes, very good. It's a plural term. And tell me what type of noun it is. Okay, it's a material noun. So furniture is made of wood or any other material. So that wood or plastic or iron, they are called materials, and furniture is a common noun. Clear? Okay, it's not a material noun, it's a common noun. And tell me whether it's a countable one or an uncountable one. It's an uncountable noun. Why? Because if there is only one chair present in the room, we call it as a furniture only. And at the same time, if there are number of chairs present in the room, at that time also we call it as a furniture only. Okay, so furniture do not have a plural form. If it is singular or plural, we call it as furniture only. Okay, so furniture is both, is used for both. It's also a singular. Clear? Is that clear? Okay. Okay, so now we shall try to make the plural for the words, the nouns. Okay, I'll give you a set of words and also I'll tell you the rule to change it into a plural form. Okay. So in one shot, can you tell what type of nouns they are? In one glance, can you say what type of nouns they are? You have to give me a perfect answer. What type of nouns are these? So they all have a common thing. What is that? Yes, these are all common nouns. Yes, it's correct. And also they are countable nouns. Okay, they are also countable nouns. So whenever we see a countable noun, we can form the plural of it by simply adding s at its last. Okay, so the rule is the plural for a countable noun can be obtained by adding the letter s at its last. Okay, so whenever we see a countable noun, just remember that if we see a countable noun, we can form its plural by simply adding s at its last. Okay, so ant, what is the plural for ant? Ants. Anyhow, these all, you know, aeroplanes, hands, trees, ears, hands. Okay, so that is the first rule. Is it clear? Is it clear about it? Okay, next one. So for common or countable nouns, we can form the plural by simply adding s at its last. And next one is, see these words. Okay, just take these words: bus, class, bench, bush, box, quiz, gas, church, buzz. So do you find anything common in all these words? Do you find anything common in all these words? Okay, so there is nothing common. Anyhow, they are the common nouns only. So the rule is yes. Yes. And next, CH. Just observe the last letters present here. Okay. Just observe the last letters that are present here. So when we observe the last letters, we find these letters at the last of the words. What are they? First one is S, CH, SH, X, Z. Okay, if the singular noun ends with any of these letters, then the plural of it is formed by adding ES at its last. So that is the rule. Okay. Is formed by any of the above letters at its last, then the plural for that word ends with yes at its last. Clear? Is it clear? So if any of the words end with either s, among all these ones like s, ch, sh, x, z, then the plural of it is formed by adding es at its last. So now write the plurals for each one. Write all the plurals. Tell me the plurals. So anyhow, you know, I feel, you know, buses, classes, benches, bushes, boxes, quizzes, okay, gases, churches, budges. Okay, so what did we do here? We simply added yes at its last because these words are ending with the letters S, CH, SH, X, and Z. So is that clear?